Good evening, one and all. Good evening to all the distinguished speakers, guests, and participants. I welcome you all to the webinar on rural primary health, followed by prize distribution ceremony of article writing competition jointly organized by Council for Green Revolution and Family Planning Association of India, Hyderabad. Council for Green Revolution is an environmental organization founded on 22nd April 2010. It works for the protection of the environment and promotes sustainable development. The organization primarily focuses on the restoration of damaged ecosystems and nurturing earth leadership. In these successful 11 years, CGR has facilitated 3.4 million saplings by reaching out to 1 million school children and youth largely from rural Telangana and Andhra Pradesh. CGR works in partnerships in implementing the sustainable development goals based on goal number 3, good health and well-being. CGR has associated with Family Planning Association of India, Hyderabad, to address the issues of rural primary health. The thought emerged at the outbreak of COVID-19, where everyone was very eager to look how India, being a very populous country, would tackle and control the spread of the pandemic, all thanks to the doctors and frontline workers who have tirelessly worked day and night to control the spread efficiently, especially in the rural areas. An article writing competition was announced in June 2020 in two categories, category 1 for the medical practitioners, category 2 for the paramedical staff, ANMs, Anganwadis, social workers, journalists and others, where we can capture the issues in the rural primary health setting and get the practical, feasible and local based solutions from ground level. We have received 60 articles in both categories. It will be bought as an ebook in the very recent future. And the best articles will be announced today at the end of the webinar. Now I invite Srimati Leela Lakshma Reddy Garu, President of CGR, to kindly give the welcome address.
Good evening to all. It's my pleasure to invite the dignitaries and the participants in this need of the hour webinar on rural primary health. This is the culmination ceremony of a competition on the above theme in collaboration between Family Planning Association Hyderabad and the Council for Green Revolution. I invite today's chief guest, Dr. Padmaja Garu, Chief Medical Officer, GHMC. I invite Dr. Ambuja Choranur, President, FPAI Hyderabad. I invite Dr. P. Balamba, Eminent Health Specialist. I invite Dr. Priya Kumari, faculty, Nizam College, and founder of Palliative Care Society, Dr. Kameshwari Vinjamuri, Life HRG. I welcome Sri K. Lakshma Reddy Garu, founder of CGR. I welcome Dr. Maheshwar, scientist, NIM. I welcome Dr. Sai Bhaskar Reddy, director, the Earth Center. I welcome Dr. Surya Prakash Vinjamuri, co-founder Life HRG. I welcome the medical professionals, journalists, social workers and others who have joined in this webinar and prize distribution ceremony. I hope this webinar, the essays from the competitions will help the promoting a better health services in the rural areas. I wish all the best and I congratulate the winners and appreciate all the participants in the webinar. Thank you, Yashwan. Thank you.
Thank you so much, madam. Now let's move on to the lamplighting ceremony. Let us start today's program with lamplighting ceremony, which is when we get back to our sacred text, which says Tamasoma Jyotirgamaya, which means may the light of knowledge remove the darkness of ignorance. Let us all pray Goddess Saraswati of knowledge, Ma Saraswati, to lead us in the path of light through the darkness of ignorance. Now I request the AV team to play the lamp lighting.
Shubham Kalyanam Arogyam Dhana Sampada Shubham Kurutvam Kalyanam Arogyam Dhana Sampada Shatru Buddhi Vinashaya Deepat Jyotir Namostute Deepat Jyotir Namostute Shubham Kurutvam Kalyanam Arogyam Dhana Sampada Shubham Kurutvam Kalyanam
Now we would like to move to the main sessions. Now I would like to invite Dr. Ambuja Charanur Garu, President of Family Planning Association of India, Hyderabad chapter, to kindly address. Before that, I would like to give a small brief introduction of Dr. Ambuja Garu. Professor Dr. Ambuja Chernur, MD DGO, is a retired professor and head of the Department of Government Maternity Hospital, Osmania Medical College, and a visiting professor for obstetrics and gynecology, Savita University. She is also the president of Family Planning Association of India, Hyderabad branch, and Central Executive Committee of Family Planning Association of India. Thank you, madam. We welcome you. Over to you.
Good evening, everybody. All the dignitaries and the efficient people, eminent people that are present. Today it is being the Council for Green Revolution along with Family Planning Association of India. We are jointly organizing webinar on rural primary health. And thanks to CGR people for giving us the opportunity to arrange and judge the papers that are presented. I really congratulate all the winners and appreciate all the participants. And this is really a very good insight to know how many people are aware of the things that are going on and how we are going to improve the post-COVID conditions in the PHC. Actually, the goal of doing this is to attain the, to reach Sustainable Development Goal 3, that is the maternal and child health care, and to reduce the maternal mortality and perinatal mortality and to give a comprehensive health care to everybody. For this matter, our Family Planning Association is deeply involved. Actually, I'd like to tell a few things about the Family Planning Association. Family Planning Association of India is a social organization delivering essential health services focusing on sexual and reproductive health in 18 states of India. It is established in 1951 and it has got 7 decades of experience in the field of sexual and reproductive health. It works in close partnership with central and state governments, NGOs, and national and international organizations. The branch was started with an aim to promote family planning, thereby improving women's health, by Dr. Mrs. K. Velodi, who was the first president of the branch. For over 7 years, it has done a lot of service. Apart from the family planning, there are other things which I am going to show it. In keeping with the objective of FPA India, the branch provides high quality services that are affordable through its units, namely the tubectomy, vasectomy, and counseling is the part which is very, very important, taken care of it at affordable rate. And tubectomy is being done for below poverty line for only 800 rupees, which is the cost which we are encountering. And it is a comprehensive abortion care and contraception is being taken care, which is really neglected field in most of the places. Immunization for children and expectant mothers is being done. And nutrition is the one which is given lot of importance, and so many times nutritive products at a low cost are being distributed to them. Adolescent healthcare issues are being taken care, and we have a good counselor who goes to schools and conducts the adolescent health programs. We have adopted 3 urban slums in Hyderabad, that is B.S. Makta, M.S. Makta, and Rajanagar, where we regularly visit them and create awareness regarding everything. Even Mare Innovative Projects is being done. It is not only about the family planning, it is the all the health issues that are dealt in these areas. Other services, not only though it is aim is only family planning services, we are providing other services, that is integrated services for STI, reproductive tract infections, and HIV infections. Prevention and early detection and management of reproductive tract cancers. This is mainly is being done to create awareness for the public that so many preventable cancers are present which are taken care, like breast cancer, the cervical cancer, pap smears, VIA, and wherever it is necessary, cryocautery is done and colposcopy is being done. This is to tell them that so many cancers are preventable, they should be aware of these things. And counseling for gender-based violence is done very regularly. A specific SRH services for young people and for the elderly is being done. Male innovation project to create awareness among men to take care of women and to prevent atrocities against the female gender. And this is what some of the things which awareness programs which we have done. And one is the gender-based violence, that a program is being done in the metro stations to create awareness, and the skit is being done in some of the slum areas. This is in the Rajanagar that is done. And under the banner of the Family Planning Association of India, skill development training and distribution of the sewing machines that are done. Yeah, at this juncture, I'd like to remind that it is the hard work of the previous presidents that are done and the volunteers who have contributed a lot to the improvement of the Family Planning Association of Hyderabad. This is supposed to be the first best in the country. We should remember Dr. Mrs. Velodi, who is the founder president, and Premlata Gupta, who is responsible to fetch the land which we are occupying right now. Ramesh Gandhi and Nandini Gandhi are the people who were the pillars of the Family Planning Association. Dr. Gilda, who is instrumental in building the present building. And along with that, Dr. K. Satyanarayan Rao and Kumudini Madam and Balamba Madam, they all work for the betterment of the Family Planning Association of India. This is the photos, the Ramesh Gandhi, Nandini Gandhi and Premlata. And I want to tell what we have done for the COVID response. Though we could not attend the hospital for about 2 months, afterwards, we regularly, all our staff have attended and created awareness programs for all these things about the washing of the hands, wearing the mask, maintaining the distance. Each and every where we have distributed the masks and sanitary sanitizers to them. And ISA programs are being conducted in many areas. And mega health camp, even though at this time also we have conducted in Domalguda and distributed all the food products to the needy people with our own money. Volunteers have donated for this. And for the gender-based violence to create awareness, and adolescent girl programs are being done in many areas. This is the human rights awareness that is being done in Panjagutta, where the N.T. Ramarao statue also we are able to see. And afterwards, they all came to one place where counseling is done for all the people. So this is what is the Family Planning India is doing for the betterment to achieve the Millennium Development Goal. And at this juncture, I request all of you to contribute something or other by becoming members at least to the Family Planning of India and to do a more of social service to the public. Thank you very much for giving the opportunity. Thank you all.
Thank you so much, madam, for your kind words about Family Planning Association of India and its activities. Now, I would like to invite Dr. Balamba Garu to speak about her experiences in rural primary health. Before that, I would like to give a very brief introduction about Dr. Balamba Garu. She is the former additional medical superintendent, Osmania General Hospital, and former head of the Department of OD and Gynecology, Osmania Medical College. She's also the governing body chairperson for Prajwala NGO, which works in trafficking. Thank you, madam, for joining us today. Please share your experiences on rural primary health. Over to you, madam.
Thank you, Ashwath. I think, you know, I'm quite qualified in talking about rural health because I started my service in rural area. When I passed my MBBS, those days, you know, we got our postings, government postings immediately after passing MBBS. So I was posted to a place known as Pathikonda in Karnool district, which I didn't even know that it existed. Well, my parents educated us, all of us, all the girls, and they said, having educated you, you have to go and serve because the government wants you to serve in the rural area. So I went there, and it is still, as I am told, is a one street town, supposed to be a town, but it is not a town actually. But then, you know, it had a good infrastructure. There was a nice hospital, a theater, but no quarters for us. I had to literally search for a quarter, you know, and I ultimately stayed in a social welfare hostel, warden's quarter, because warden was absent there, and she was traveling from Karnool to Pathikonda every day. So I occupied that place. And those days, you know, the parents never thought that having qualified, we should stay only in the city. Unfortunately, the situation has changed now. But it gives you so much of insight when you work in a rural area. Their wants, what is it that they need in the matters of health, whether it is a preventive or curative or counseling or whatever type of health. And I learned so much because that is where, you know, I got my confidence to be independent, to look after patients and to become bold in taking decisions. And I think, you know, at present it is lacking in almost all the, even the so-called postgraduates. When with our MBBS degree, you know, we could serve those people. We were well-equipped to serve those people in all fields. Like I said, preventive and then curative services also. And we could do that. But then, you know, the infrastructure was not so good. There were no roads. But now the infrastructure has improved a lot tremendously. The PHCs have been gifted with nice buildings, in spite of which we see that most of the PHCs lack medical officers. It is not only medical officers, because we all stayed in our headquarters those days, in the premises, in the hospital-based town, but now nobody wants to stay there. They all want to stay in the nearby town. Then, you know, they travel to the PHC, including the ANMs, the nurses. And the public health system at that point of time was different. There was a health visitor, there was an ANM. But now they have integrated the services, made them into multipurpose health workers. And the multipurpose health workers are really burdened with so many things to do. Ultimately, they are ending up doing nothing. But we have come a long way since then. The maternal mortality ratio has come down tremendously because the ASHA workers were introduced and the multi-purpose health workers, who are also midwives, you know, they go from house to house. They are recording who is pregnant in that particular village. And then, you know, they are taking care of them. And the reference services have improved tremendously because the roads have improved. Now we have 108 ambulance, which caters to all these emergencies. But the only problem with these emergency services is the vehicle should be in good condition. Petrol should be available. All this has to be supplied and the driver has to be available. The roads have to be maneuverable. So these are all the things. Because in those days, you know, we used to get patients who traveled by tractors. Now, even in some areas, even today we are seeing patients being transported manually. I have seen even doctors carrying patients. And these are the things, you know, which we'll have to look at. So it is not only the curative. And then the local problems have to be tackled. What are the local requirements? And the most important thing will be sanitation as well as potable water. If we can provide these two, I think sanitation and potable water, which is an environmental problem, then, you know, we can prevent most of the communicable diseases. And then, of course, in the urban areas as well as in the rural areas, now we have got non-communicable diseases, which is becoming real epidemic. Apart from the epidemic that we are facing now, immunizations have improved, antenatal care has improved, intranatal care has improved, maternal mortality, like I said, has come down, but I think we have a long way to go and we have to really concentrate on how to motivate our young doctors to go and work in the rural areas. One of the problems that these doctors face in the rural areas is accommodation and schooling for their children. So it is not like when we were students or when we just passed MBBS. Now they have to wait at least for 10 to 15 years before they get a government posting. And by that time, you know, they are married, having children and settled somewhere within private practice. So I think, you know, the government should think of setting up some sort of a system where the couple are posted in a area together instead of the husband in one place and the wife in another place and the children somewhere else. And they have to provide at least some sort of means, you know, maybe remuneration or whatever, to see that the children are educated in a good school. Because in the villages, you know, the schools may not be available for these children. So once they do all these things, you know, I think the rural health will improve. And of course, we'll have to cooperate with the local governments, the panchayats, the sarpanches, and the local people have to be involved. So I think, you know, once we do all these things, we will be able to achieve the sustainable goal, which the WHO is envisaging. The government is doing its bit, but I think, you know, as a medical community, we also have to do our bit. Thank you very much for giving me this opportunity.
Thank you so much, madam, for your kind words and your experience, immense experience. Now, I would like to invite our next speaker, Dr. D. Priya Kumari Garu. She would be speaking on importance of palliative care. And let me just give you a brief introduction of her. She started working as an assistant professor for zoology in Nizam College, Osmania University. She has 22 years of teaching experience in both undergraduate and postgraduate level. She is the founder member of Pain and Palliative Care Society, PRPCS, Hyderabad. She is also the executive member of Council for Green Revolution and Greens Alliance for Conservation of Eastern Ghats. She thrives for the advocacy of palliative care and environmental concern issues in close association with CGR. We welcome you, ma'am. Thank you so much. Please, the stage, over to you, madam.
Thank you, Ashwant, for that kind introduction. I would need your help to present my few slides. And I would take over this my talk on palliative care on behalf, like from the points Madam Ambuja ji and Valamba madam has rightly pointed out regarding the rural health problems, and even being so science and technologically advanced, even today we are still facing some very crucial challenges, ma'am. I think it's a long way to go ahead before we actually address these challenges and provide good care to the people who are suffering in this rural communities, especially in the rural communities. Thank you for the CGR for giving me this opportunity. So I just would like to present my slides. So I want to talk about this lady from whom I have learned so many things in my life, and she has changed my lifestyle so much. This lady is has traveled from Adilabad district to come to MNJ Cancer Hospital, where I volunteer for palliative care. And she was suffering from cancer of cervix. And when she came, she was in this posture for many months. She was not sleeping straight. She had a very bad pain and foul-smelling discharge, and a lot of anxiety and fear. Along with her, she had two children with her. One is age 6 and one was age 8. And they were crying and she was panic. And she was smelling so much that the whole corridor was smelling of her foul smelling discharge because of the cancer. So at this stage she has come. So then this is what she was requesting us. She asked us to kill her. And she says, kill me because I can't bear this pain anymore. And my doctors have given up in Adilabad, saying that nothing can be done for you. And she hails from a very, very rural village of Adilabad district. In that pain and suffering, she traveled all the way to Hyderabad to just get the pain relief. So somewhere the health system in the rural setting might have failed, that she has traveled all this way to reach to Hyderabad. And she didn't have any support system because of her foul smell. People have alienated her because they said that some demonic presence is there with her. That's why she's smelling so bad. And the children were not allowed to play with other children, thinking that their mother has some deadly disease and that will spread to them. And husband leaves her because she was no more giving him the pleasure and all the joy what he was expected from her. And this is the stage where she has traveled. So there are many kind of such patients in the rural communities. When we talk of the burden of non-communicable diseases, most of them are suffering and they are dying with some amount of pain or any other symptom. And WHO says that about 67% of the cancer patients report to the hospitals in in most advanced stage, and eventually all of them have pain. And most of them do not get any kind of a pain relief in the communities. So there comes the role of the palliative care, wherein the palliative care provides an active total care of the patients with advanced progressive diseases and life-limiting diseases, which aims at control of their pain and other symptoms, psychological pain, social burden, and spiritual burden of the patients, and it addresses them totally and gives a total care to the patients. So we try to address all her physical problems. More than the physical problems, she was suffering from social isolation. She was emotionally broken down because she was not knowing what to do with those two children. What could be their future? How are they going to be taken care of? So that were her most emotional stress and spiritual burden. And she was always questioning God, why God is doing to me like this? Why is that I am in this pain? Why is God punishing me though I was very good woman taking care of my family and etc.? So if you just address to the physical problems, the other burden is so much that even if you give medication, she is not going to be peaceful. So we try to reduce her suffering, and there we have a very good team of palliative care physicians. So Dr. Gayatri Palat is the head in charge of this operations, and together that we have established this NGO Pain Relief and Palliative Care Society in 2007. It offers its services in MNJ Cancer Hospital, have a in-bed facility called as Hospice Center in Kukatpally with 21 bed facilities. 6 home care vans going to the house to house in the city, offering the care right at their home, wherein we call this program as a Life at Your Doorstep program. We support the patients who come to MNJ Cancer Hospital because they are all below poverty line. They don't even have a morsel of food to eat properly, all the 3 meals. So in that case, we try to support their medication, their travel, etc. And we also have a very good pediatric palliative care program. And seeing this work of Pain Relief and Palliative Care Society, Government of Telangana has invited this NGO to be their knowledge partners and to set up all this district or rural palliative care centers right in their hometown, because this kind of a people whose story I was talking about, Sitamma, there are n number of such patients who are lacking any kind of care right in their rural setting. So we have worked with the communities and first initiated our program in Chevela Mandal, where we have covered all the villages, did door-to-door survey, identified the patients and given them this palliative care. So today we are acting as knowledge partners, trying to establish this kind of centers in the rural settings. So luckily, palliative care was incorporated in India's national health policy in 2017. And that was added as the strength. And especially I should appreciate the Commissioner of Health of Telangana government. She is a very pioneering lady and she's really going ahead establishing the centers in the palliative in the state of Telangana under NHM scheme. And we have started establishing the centers in the districts. So the advantage of that is this lady again was in a rural setting. She had have a hip fracture and she was lying there for months together with nobody to care to. So with our team going and doing the survey, we could identify, and this is right in a very remote village where health services are there to go and give her any kind of a service to them. So such kind of people die in pain and suffering without any dignity. So we, at the first phase, we have already established centers in 8 districts: Adilabad, Siddipet, Warangal, then Khammam, Warangal, Yadadri district, then Mehboob Nagar, and Rangareddy in Chevela. So eventually, in the phase 2, we have started another 10 centers who are right now undergoing training in Family Health and Welfare Institute in Sanjeev Reddy Nagar. They are all come here. About 45 professionals are undergoing training. Maybe in 1 month or 2, we will be starting another 10 centers. 18 centers will be functional in few months. And eventually, by another 6 months, we plan to establish all such centers in every district of Telangana. So people like Sitamma need not travel from Adilabad to Hyderabad to just get the simple medication, that is morphine, which could relieve her pain and suffering. That's the end of my presentation. So whatever we have set up in the districts, so the team comprises of a medical doctor, 5 staff nurses, 2 ANNs, 1 driver, 1 home care van. So the home care van moves in the district villages and does the survey, identify the patients, provides home care, it provides the OP services, it provides inpatient services. And regarding this in topic, none of the, even in the medical system, people do not have awareness, because people don't talk much of death and dying, but eventually we are going to die one day, and we all would like to die in dignity, but not in pain and suffering. There is palliative care to provide you a dignified death. Thank you for this opportunity. Thank you, Leela Madam, Lakshman Reddy Sir, and Yashwant for this opportunity. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for the brief introduction about the palliative care and its need in the rural areas. Now we would like to move on to the next session by Dr. Mekam Maheshwar Garu. He will be talking about nutrition in rural primary health. I just want to give you a few lines about Dr. Maheshwar sir. He possesses 32 years of experience in journalism, mass media, nutrition, communication, research and public relations. He obtained PhD and MPhil in nutrition and health communication. He is currently working as a Deputy Director, Scientist E, and Head of the Department, Extension of Training, ICMR, National Nutrition, Hyderabad. His specialization is health communication, nutrition communication, and mass media. He involved and completed various studies and analysis of mass media and nutrition sciences coverage. He published more than a dozen research papers in various international research journals. He involved in translation of nutrition knowledge into public health domain by dissemination of information. He explores optimum possibilities for propagating nutrition knowledge and raise awareness levels of the people through mass media. He conceptualized, scripted, and directed many creative short films of non-nutrition and health lifestyle to disseminate through various tools and mass media, including television channels. Thank you, sir. We are very happy to have you here today. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Mr. Yashwant, for a nice introduction. Thank you very much. And good evening, everyone, once again. Respected dignitaries, viewers, participants, first and foremost, I congratulate all the winners of competition and appreciate all whoever has contributed their articles for this competition. I'm thankful to Family Planning Association of India and Council for Green Revolution, particularly Lakshman Reddy Garu and Leela Madam Garu, for organizing this webinar and giving me this fine opportunity. Now the topic for today's webinar, rural primary health, is so broad and wide that It is difficult to anyone to touch all the aspects of this topic as it involves many, many diversified factors. However, I confine my speech to nutrition angle in the restricted time allotted to me. Here, we have to notice that without nutrition, health is not possible. To elaborate, without healthy lifestyle, lifestyle includes nutritious food, or we call it as balanced diet, and physical activity. So it is not possible to achieve complete health without life, physical activity and healthy eating habits, either individual or nation, whether in rural or urban areas. Nutrition and physical activity should both go together. These two are two decisive factors for maintenance of optimal health. Hence, nutrition is an important precondition for maintenance of complete health. But many surveys conducted in the last 2-3 decades are showing a bleak picture of nutrition status of our country, particularly in rural areas and even in urban areas, including major cities. I will share brief statistics of a longitudinal study conducted to measure nutrition status of rural areas as an example. During the last 25 years, a large database has been accumulated on the diet and nutrition status of the rural population of different states of India. We at ICMR, National Institute of Nutrition and Nutrition Monitoring Bureau, has carried out extensive diet and nutrition surveys in 12 big states of the country. These surveys indicated that the diets of the rural population are inadequate and deficient in most of the nutrients. There is widespread energy deficiency in the rural households. About 60% of the preschool children are underweight and 62% are stunted. About 52% of the children of 1 to 5 years of age suffer from short duration malnutrition, that is called as wasting. During these 3 decades, repeat surveys showed that though severe malnutrition has declined substantially in children, there was reduction in the extent of chronic energy deficiency among the adults. But however, there were no perceptible changes in the diet and nutrient intakes during the past 20 years. On the other side, in our country, more than 60% of women are suffering with at least one kind of anemia, that is mild, moderate, or severe. That means 2 in every 3 women are suffering with anemia, irrespective of their economic status. This undernutrition problem is more in women of rural areas, particularly among the women in reproductive age. As a result, delivering low birth weight infants is not uncommon in rural areas. If that infant happens to be a girl and undernourished during her childhood and adolescent age, she too undergoes iron deficiency anemia and after her marriage delivers low birth babies. Thus, it leads to a vicious cycle of undernutrition problem in our country. So now one of the ways to overcome malnutrition among the population is awareness about food and healthy lifestyle. Building up awareness is very important. People should know the ill consequences of unhealthy food habits and faulty lifestyle, as this would push them to the risk of non-communicable diseases like hypertension, diabetes, and even after hypertension and diabetes, if they do not take care, it could lead to another heart problems and stroke problems. It is unfortunate to mention that more publicity is happening to unhealthy foods or junk foods over healthy foods. Particularly after globalization, the determinants of dietary behavior have drastically changed, including in rural areas. In globalized world, where even rural areas are not immune, food habits have undergone a sea change and have impacted Indian lifestyle in general and food habits of children and youth in particular. In the case of double income, single kid nuclear families, that is wife, husband, and single child, affordability of ready-to-eat foods have gone up, resulting in a shift in dietary behavior. Added to this, feeds marketing techniques use media to disseminate enticing messages, which has culminated in increased sales of ready-to-eat foods, that is junk foods. junk foods which contain excess caloric value with nil or inadequate micronutrients is another major reason for prevalence of nutrition deficiency. Needless to emphasize, junk foods are posing a threat to the wellness and fitness of individuals. Though junk foods, that is called as quick foods, are a matter of convenience, the nutritive value of such foods is always in question. Please notice, traditional foods rich in nutrition are slowly fading out of Indian kitchens. Non-availability of traditional eatables coupled with lack of awareness is resulting in westernization of eating habits. In this scenario, building up awareness levels of people about healthy food habits is the only solution to overcome malnutrition in order to pave way for complete health and prevent non-communicable diseases. Of course, accessibility to healthy foods is also one of the major factors. In this direction, Government of India is implementing a massive project named as Poshan Abhiyan. Under this, NIN also took active part in disseminating of nutrition information through e-learning modules. We have produced more than a dozen e-learning modules on nutrition and health topics of 20 to 25 minutes duration, and all these videos are available on our website. These e-modules, each of these e-modules are meant for little literate people who can understand easily. So they can watch these videos and they can even answer the questions after this video, and they can generate a certificate for themselves as they have awareness on those topics. In addition to this Poshan Abhiyan project, all the state governments are executing various programs for improvement of nutrition status of the people, like Anganwadi, midday meal programs, etc. The list is unending. But this is not enough. All the sections of the society, including NGOs, schools and colleges particularly, should join in improving awareness levels of people. Particularly, schools should introduce basic knowledge of nutrition into their curriculum. Each school should have a nutrition club and devote daily at least half an hour on nutrition related topics, discussion and creating awareness among the children. Let our children know about healthy food and unhealthy foods right from the budding age. Let us inculcate in the minds of our children about ill consequences of bad food habits and unhealthy lifestyle. Undernutrition is not a problem of an individual or a section of or an area. It is a problem of nation. Hence, let us strive together to overcome this deficiency in order to build a healthy nation. With this, I conclude my speech, and I thanks once again the organizer for giving me this opportunity. Thank you. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you so much, sir. Now I would like to move on to the next session, where we have our distinguished guests with us. Sir, I would like to have a few minutes of yours, Dr. Sai Bhaskar Reddy sir, Dilip Reddy sir, and Lakshman Reddy sir, and Dr. Surya Prakash Garu, to share your views one by one. Now I call upon Dr. N. Sai Bhaskar Reddy Garu, Director of Earth Center, Council for Green Revolution, to share his views.
Good evening, everyone. Today it's an important event that we are declaring the participants in our competition, especially on rural health. And I have gone through the articles. They are very good. They have covered all the aspects. Probably more people could have participated in this particular competition, but maybe because of their schedules, especially the people in the health sector, it had been very busy during this COVID times, and still they could contribute. And most importantly, the primary sector, where even there is demand under the GDP, the percentage of increase, the spending, we are waiting for the budget now to come. Hope there is enough allocations, especially in the rural primary health sector, as well as overall in the health sector, with this difficult times that we are undergoing. And there is a lot that is need to be done in this especially reaching the unreached, that is the poorest of the poor. And the health is a major concern for everyone, whether rich or poor. And even the research that need to be done, and the outreach, and especially the paramedics or medical fraternity, and the civil society role, and all these are very, very important. And I hope all these things will fall in line soon, and there will be more focus on these issues from all levels, that is including the government, and we do better in this sector. Thank you very much, Ishwan. Thank you all for this opportunity to speak.
Thank you so much, sir. Sorry. Now I request Lakshma Reddy Garu, founder of Council for Green Revolution and executive committee member for Family Planning Association of India Hyderabad chapter, to speak few words.
Andariki namaskaralu. So ee roju manam primary health gurinchi competition nu cheppe mundu mana organization Council for Green Revolution anedi ippati varaku oka 11 samvatsaral nunchi పర్యావరణ ఎన్విరాన్మెంట్ లో పనిచేసుకుంటూ వస్తున్నాం. ఒక 9 లక్షల మంది విద్యార్థులను మోటివేట్ చేసి ఒక 36 లక్షల మొక్కలు నాటించగలిగినాం ఒక రూరల్లో. సో దాంట్లో దాంతో పాటు సస్టైనబుల్ డెవలప్మెంట్ గోల్స్ అనే ఐటాన్ని తీసుకొని అందులో భాగంగా ఈ హెల్త్ మీద ఉన్నో ఎడ్యుకేషన్ మీద కాంపిటీషన్ పెట్టడం జరిగింది. దాంట్లో భాగంగానే సస్టైనబుల్ డెవలప్మెంట్ గోల్ కింద ఈ హెల్త్ ను ప్రైమరీ రూరల్ హెల్త్ మన ముఖ్యంగా హెల్త్ అండ్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ వెరీ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్. ఇప్పుడు మనం కోవిడ్ వచ్చిన తర్వాత చూస్తున్నాం హెల్త్ గురించి చాలా ఇంపార్టెన్స్ అయింది. ఆ సందర్భంగా మనం ఆర్టికల్స్ కాల్ ఫర్ చేస్తే బాగుంటది అనే ఉద్దేశంతో మన ఫ్యామిలీ ప్లానింగ్ అసోసియేషన్ తోని మీటింగ్ లో మాట్లాడి అందరు బాలమ్మ గారు అంబుజ మేడం అందరు ఉన్నారు అందరితో మాట్లాడి ఈ నిర్ణయం తీసుకోవటం జరిగింది. దీంట్లో భాగంగానే ఈరోజు ఎంతో మన ముఖ్య గెస్ట్ అందరూ మిగతా వాళ్ళందరూ వచ్చారు. అందరు వాళ్ళ వాళ్ళ అభిప్రాయాలు వాళ్ళ న్యూట్రిషన్ గురించి అయితేంది, ప్యాలిటివ్ కేర్ గురించి అయితేంది, రకరకాల బాలమ్మ గారు వారి ఎక్స్పీరియన్స్ ఎట్లా ఉంటే బాగుంటది అనేది కూడా రకరకాలుగా చెప్పడం జరిగింది. సో వీళ్ళందరి మనకు ఒక ఏదన్నా రూరల్ హెల్త్ బాగుండేటట్టుగా మనం అందరం కలిసి ఒకటి కంట్రిబ్యూట్ ఏదన్నా ఏదో రకంగా కంట్రిబ్యూట్ చేయగలిగితే బాగుంటది అనే ఉద్దేశంతో దీన్ని పెట్టడం జరిగింది. దీని గురించి ఇంకా మిగతా వాళ్ళు మాట్లాడి దాని గురించి మనం ఏదన్నా ఎంతో అంతో రూరల్లో ప్రజలకు నలుగురికి ఉపయోగపడేలా ఆలోచన చేయాలని మిమ్మల్ని అందరినీ కోరుకుంటూ వచ్చిన గెస్ట్లందరూ చాలా చక్కగా చెప్పారు. మిగతా నేను దీంతో ముగిస్తున్నా.
థ్యాంక్ యూ సో మచ్ సార్. నౌ ఐ వుడ్ లైక్ టు ఇన్వైట్ అవర్ చీఫ్ గెస్ట్ ఫర్ టుడేస్ ఈవెంట్, డాక్టర్ పద్మజ గారు, చీఫ్ మెడికల్ ఆఫీసర్ ఆఫ్ జిహెచ్ఎంసి. బిఫోర్ స్టార్టింగ్ ఐ వుడ్ లైక్ టు గివ్ అ వెరీ బ్రీఫ్ ఇంట్రొడక్షన్ అబౌట్ హర్. Dr. Padmaja Garu is a very dedicated and efficient DM and HO. She has been appreciated several times for her efficient services in the family welfare activities for the year 2014 to 2015, 2009 to 2010 and 2008 to 2011 continuously. She has received many appreciations and awards for her services. We are very happy to have you here today, ma'am. Please take over, madam. Thank you.
Good evening, everybody. We are all the dignitaries. Dr. Ambuja Madam, Dr. Balamba Madam, దిలీప్ రెడ్డి సార్, డాక్టర్ కామేశ్వరి గారు, డాక్టర్ లీలా లక్ష్మారెడ్డి గారు, డాక్టర్ లక్ష్మారెడ్డి గారు, డాక్టర్ సాయి భాస్కర్ రెడ్డి గారు, డాక్టర్ సూర్యప్రకాష్ గారు అండ్ యశ్వంత్ గారు. ఇట్స్ మై ప్రివిలేజ్ టు బి హియర్ విత్ యూ టు అటెండింగ్ దిస్ వెబినార్. యాక్చువల్లీ ఐ డెంట్ ప్రిపేర్ ఎనీ స్లైడ్స్ మేడం. విత్ మై teachers, Balamba Madam and Ambuja Madam, I am attending this meeting. It's very happy to me. After hearing Balamba Madam, I want to share my startings in service experiences. In 91, I joined in the service in 1991, Madam. The surrounding area of the Bhadrachalam, only one red bus in the morning, one red bus in the evening. We used to do health camps and family planning camps also. Not laparoscopy, family tubectomy camps, madam.
Yes.
All the stretchers also we used to take on RTC bus all. On the bus, top of the bus. used to do like that. In starting of service, మేము నేర్చుకునేటప్పుడు మేమే నేర్చుకుంటున్నామంటే ఒక సీనియర్ ని డెప్యుటేషన్ వేసుకొని మాతో పాటు ఇంకొక ఆయన నేర్చుకొని ఒకరోజు పొద్దు 6 అయితే అక్కడ కరెంటు చాలా తగ్గిపోద్ది. అట్లాంటి గుడ్ లైట్ లో మేము ట్యూబెక్టమీ ఆపరేషన్లు చేసేవాళ్ళం. ఆయన ఇంటర్స్టైన్ కట్ చేశాడు. సో మాకు డెప్యుటేషన్ వచ్చిన సీనియర్ సర్జన్ చాలా బాగా హ్యాండిల్ చేసి క్లోజ్ చేశారు. అట్లా వి యూజ్ టు డూ హెల్త్ క్యాంప్స్, ఫ్యామిలీ ప్లానింగ్ క్యాంప్స్, క్యాన్సర్ సర్వీస్ స్క్రీనింగ్ క్యాంప్స్, టీవీ స్క్రీనింగ్ క్యాంప్స్ లైక్ దట్. ఇన్ ఎపిడెమిక్స్ ఆల్సో వి యూజ్ టు స్టే దేర్ ఇన్ దేర్ హట్స్ డేస్ టుగెదర్ టు ప్రివెంట్ ద డెత్స్. వి యూజ్ టు గివ్ ఐవీ ఫ్లూయిడ్స్. After that, in area hospital Bhadrachalam, from there also we used to go while traveling 2 to 3 hours interior places for laparoscopy, family planning operations, along with the teams. I used to sing all the way songs only. Used to singing. వాళ్ళందరికీ అలసట వెలవకుండా 3 hours ఆ జీప్ లో ఇంటీరియర్ ప్లేస్ మా క్యాంప్ కు రీచ్ అయ్యే వరకు పాటలు పాడుకుంటూ వెళ్లే వాళ్ళం. దే యూజ్ టు ఎంజాయ్ మై సాంగ్. ఇంకా ఏరియా హాస్పిటల్ భద్రాచలంలో ఐ వాజ్ ద ఓన్లీ లేడీ డాక్టర్ టు అటెండ్ ద సరౌండింగ్ ఆల్ మండల్స్ రేప్ కేసెస్ అండ్ ఐ యూజ్ టు గో ఎవ్రీ ఆల్టర్నేట్ డే టు ద కోర్ట్ టు కొత్తగూడెం. దోస్ ఆర్ మై ట్రైబల్ అండ్ రూరల్ services experience, madam. After that, after coming and joining here additional DMHO, since around 7 to 8 years, I started family planning camps in the your family planning association with my doctors, and with that our association started from around 2007, I think. Now I am working as a JHMC CMOH. Before this, we worked in COVID center, fever hospital. We used to, we have a virology department. We conducted around 50,000 rapid tests, 25,000 RT-PCR tests, and successfully served COVID patients. And now, madam, in this first phase, the vaccination is giving for government and private, all the health staff, madam. If anybody is missing, if the list you, if you give me, I can arrange, add those lists to in the DMHO office, madam. This I can do. That's all, madam. It's very, very privileged to attend along with you, madam.
Padmaja, thank you very much for coming as chief guest. Me and Dr. Bala,
thank you, madam.
Combinedly, we decided that you are the best person because of your vast experience in the rural areas to come and tell about your views. Second thing is, because you are occupied in that position, we request you to help all the voluntary organizations, especially Family Planning Association of India, to help us in whatever things which we are deciding to do it in the remote places. That's what, along with Lakshmar Ettigar, we are thinking of reaching to the unreachable places like Armoor or Wavilala villages, which we have adopted. We are going to do in those places. If anything really we want, we request you to help us to do the things properly. And thank you very much for really coming and sparing your time in these days of the COVID, in spite of your busy schedule. Thank you so much. Now, Yashwant, you can go ahead with your...
Thank you, madam.
Thank you so much, madam. Now I request our chief guest, Dr. Padmaja Karu, to announce the winners of both the categories, category 1 and category 2. Over to you, madam.
Okay. The winners of articles writing competition and rural primary health, category 1, Pragya Shikha, first year MBBS, సెకండ్ ప్రైజ్ పి సాయిశ్రీ ఫస్ట్ ఇయర్ ఎంబీబీఎస్, థర్డ్ ప్రైజ్ తానిషా భత్తాగర్ సెకండ్ ఎంబీబీఎస్. కేటగిరీ టూ బి వేదవతి ఫిజియోథెరపిస్ట్, సెకండ్ ప్రైజ్ శంభులింగం హెచ్ఎం అసిస్టెంట్ ప్రొఫెసర్ ఎస్ఎస్ కాలేజ్ ఆఫ్ ఫార్మసీ, డాక్టర్ ఎం సురేష్ బాబు అండ్ డాక్టర్ కె భావనారాజ్ స్టేట్ ప్రెసిడెంట్ ప్రజా సైన్స్ వేదిక అండ్ అసిస్టెంట్ ప్రొఫెసర్. థ్యాంక్ యూ.
థ్యాంక్ యూ సో మచ్ మేడం. I also request Dr. Ambuja Garu to explain the whole procedure, how we have selected the entries.
Okay, I will tell. Before that, I request Lakshma Reddy Garu, we're prize money, how much it is, if you can kindly announce, it will be a great thing. What are the money amounts which you have decided and we are giving? Because it is all through the Council of Green Revolution.
The first prize for the both the categories is 20,000, madam. The second prize is 10,000 rupees, and the third prize is 5,000 rupees, madam. So these will be given as a checks for all the participants who are the winners now. So the checks will be sent to them directly.
We are all participating. I request all of them to join into the Family Planning Association, which is a real voluntary organization. We are all trying to upbring the association and do many of the social services. And we are following the footsteps of Balamma Madam, who is doing these services since 50 years. At least after retirement, we all want to join her, madam. Sir. And second thing is, how did we select the papers? That's what I wanted to tell all the participants here. We thought we'll make it as 100 as a mark. Just we should have one mark, 100 VSM. And divided it to 5 compartments, and each one means vaalla attitude towards the awareness program em untundi. So the first 20 will go to the awareness, what are the aspects they are thinking of writing their paper. Second, content em undi, for that each one has got 20 marks, and what is the content they are having. And third one is the present program elag potundi, what do they advise in the next COVID time. Like this, we have divided into 5 parts, and then we gave the marks. Of course, final selection was by Dr. Balamba because of her vast experience and work part in the PHCs. She was the right person to select. We all coordinated with her, and myself, Renu, and our family planning medical officer, we all corrected, and finally we submitted, and all these were taken into consideration. That is how it is not the one person's role. And the first route is from Dr. Lakshma Reddy and Leela Lakshma Reddy Garu, and from there it took how many months, Lakshma Reddy Garu? 6 months.
4 months, I know.
Yeah. Before that, we had 2 meetings, and then we decided after giving the subject, it took 4 months. After collection, everything is by the electronic media, and then we have corrected these things, and today is the final thing. Everything put together, it has come to this level. And thank you very much, Lakshma Reddy Garu and Leela Lakshma Reddy Garu, for giving the opportunity for us. It is a rich experience for us also, the thinking of the juniors, how it is. Some of the people have done wonderfully well. Of course, a few papers are not up to the mark, but nothing to comment on that. They have attempted, that itself is great. They have done a very good job. We know vaalla brain lo what is there, how they want to improve in future. And second thing is, yanta chesina, yemi chesina, to push doctors into the villages is really hard. As Balamba garu chepparu, conditions there, as long as it is not getting improved, many people, they would not like to go, they themselves, and even as parents manam kuda peddaga encourage cheyatam ledhu. So how to solve this problem is, ante at least we should establish medical colleges అట్లాంటి చోట ఆర్ వెరీ బిగ్ హాస్పిటల్స్ వేర్ పీపుల్ గో అండ్ వర్క్ ఇట్లాంటివేవో గవర్నమెంట్ షుడ్ థింక్. ఐ థింక్ ఇవన్నీ కూడా మనం ఆలోచించి సజెషన్స్ ఇస్తే గవర్నమెంట్కి బాగుంటుంది అని అనుకుంటున్నాను. ఏమంటారు లక్ష్మారెడ్డి గారు మీరు?
అవునమ్మా చేద్దాం.
మనకు అందరికి గైడ్ చేయడానికి మేడం ఉన్నారు, బాలమ్మ మేడం. సో ఐ థింక్ వీ విల్ డూ సంథింగ్ ఫర్ దిస్. థ్యాంక్ యూ వెరీ మచ్ ఫర్ గివింగ్ ద ఆపర్చునిటీ. నౌ వాట్ ఆఫ్ థ్యాంక్స్ బై అవర్ ఓన్ బిలవెడ్ రేణు.
థ్యాంక్ యూ మ్యామ్. రెస్పెక్టెడ్ డాక్టర్ పద్మజ, ద చీఫ్ గెస్ట్, ఆ ప్యానలిస్ట్ అండ్ స్పీకర్స్ ఫర్ టుడే ఈవెంట్స్ టుడేస్ ఈవెంట్ our most valued invited guests, winners and participants of this competition, ladies and gentlemen, it's my privilege to have been asked to propose a vote of thanks for this occasion. I, on behalf of Family Planning Association of India and Council of Green Revolution and the entire fraternity present today, and on my own behalf, I extend a hearty note of thanks to all the speakers for gracing this the important work and sharing with us your valuable thoughts and your opinions. I would first of all like to express my sincere thanks to Dr. Padmaja Garu for finding time from her busy schedule and giving her excellent coverage of her experiences of working in the rural area and how we can improve it. Further, I am grateful to Dr. Ambuja, President of Family Planning Association of India Hyderabad branch, Dr. Valamba, our past president and eminent gynecologist, Dr. Priya Kumari, founder and executive member of Palliative Care, Dr. Mekam Maheshwar, deputy director NIN, and the other speakers for their excellent insights into different aspects of rural health. Well, an event, as you all can know, you all understand that event cannot happen overnight. The wheels start rolling over weeks ago. It requires a lot of planning and bird eye view for details. We have been fortunate enough to be backed by a team of very motivated and dedicated volunteers and colleagues of Ground Council for Green Revolution, headed by Professor Mr. Lakshma Reddy and Mrs. Leewala Leela Lakshma Reddy, that we could meet this program today. We can organize this program. Without their help, we could not have organized this event. I also extend my heartfelt thanks to Mr. Yashwant, the program manager of Council of Green Revolution, who has been the backbone of this complete program, who has organized the complete logistic support, who has provided us. Thank you, Yashwan. Thank you so much. I cannot thank everyone enough for their involvement and their willingness to take on the completion of tasks beyond their comfort zones. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, I want to state that we are all most grateful to all of you and all the speakers, all the participants, all the winners of the competition, all the participants who have contributed as articles for the program. I thank you, all of you, and thank you so much for being with us. Thank you.
Thank you so much, madam. Thank you so much for, actually, there were so many days like where we have sat together and we had to call, we had to evaluate plenty of things. So those were only possible because of that continuous support from Family Planning Association of India. I would like to thank every person from FPAI Hyderabad chapter for making it as a very, very good experience for me. Thank you so much for that. Thank you so much, sir.
Bye-bye.
Thank you. Thanks, bye, everybody.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
Namaste.
Namaste, sir. Jai Hind.
Jai Hind.